Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. Not long ago, we posted the teardown of MSI 100W USB-C power adapter, and we've also tested its charging performance before taking it apart. So let's see if it really has longer peak power and better stability than mobile phone chargers. Since we already posted the teardown video of it, we'll just do a brief introduction. It adopts a black square mat design. This grounding prong can greatly reduce electric shock. It has a non-detachable USB-C cable for output, which is about 1.55 meters long. The specs info is printed on the bottom. Model is A21-100P1A. It can support input of 120 volts, 50 or 60 hertz, 1.6 amp, and the output can be up to 100 watts. It also has passed multiple certifications. The size of this adapter is about 75 by 75 by 29 millimeter, and the weight is about 290 grams. Connected to our TrigiLab Power ZKM00-C, it shows the adapter only supports PD3.0 protocol, and it also has 4 fixed PDLs. Next, let's take a look at its charging compatibility. Since it can only support PD protocol, the charging power for normal Android phones is always below 20 watts. Only a few of mobile phones, like Red Magic, can reach 25 watts. And the charging power of some tablets can be around 30 watts. It can provide almost 80 watts for laptops. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro. The voltage is always around 20 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 3 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 92 watts for the first 42 minutes. It's much longer than most high-power mobile phone chargers, like Xiaomi 210 watts charger. Then the power gradually dropped to 70 watts, 45 watts in turn in the second part. The final part begins at 1 hour and 13 minutes, and the power slowly dropped to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 9 minutes to be fully charged. We also draw it into the curve. The adapter can charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro to 44% in half an hour, and it can reach 79% in an hour, 100% in 2 hours and 9 minutes. As for the standby power part, the power consumption at 220 volts, 50 Hz is 0.123 watts and 0.022 watts at 110 volts, 60 Hz, which is about 1.08 and 0.19 kilowatts hour in 1 year, respectively. And this is pretty good in most of our standby power tests. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 85.96% to 90.71% at 220 volts, 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 86.76% to 89.41% at 110 volts, 60 Hz. The average efficiency can basically reach 90%, which shows its excellent performance. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple with no load. When the output is 9 volts, 0 amp at 110 volts, 60 Hz, the highest ripple is 62.4 millivolts peak-to-peak. When the output is 20 volts, 0 amp at 220 volts, 50 Hz, and 15 volts, 0 amp at 110 volts, 60 Hz, the lowest ripple is 38.4 millivolts peak-to-peak. Then move to the ripple when loaded. When the output is 9 volts, 3 amp at 220 volts, 50 Hz, the highest ripple is 108 millivolts peak-to-peak. When the output is 15 volts, 3 amp at 110 volts, 60 Hz, the lowest ripple is 72 millivolts peak-to-peak. And then we'll put it into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test and let it run for an hour with full load. Starting with 220 volts, 50 Hz, the maximum temperature on the front is 61.3 degrees Celsius, then the maximum temperature on the back is 59.1 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110 volts, 60 Hz, the maximum temperature on the front is 66.6 degrees Celsius, and the maximum temperature on the back is 63.6 degrees Celsius. The large size brings more heat dissipation space, so you can have a low temperature after full load, which further explains why its peak power can last so long. Well, that's all tests we made for this MSI 100W USB-C power adapter. You can use it to charge your PD-compatible devices, such as mobile phones and tablets. Because of the large size and low temperature, we can see that it has longer peak power and better stability in the full charging test, which is critical for laptop charging. And the rest of tests also show its excellent performance. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to see other videos about laptop adapters. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!